Welcome one and welcome all to the Columbus Theater. My name is Bobby Rossi. I'll be joined by Bob Whitney all evening long. We'll be your narrators for this historic event. Folks, what better way to close out 2022 than with a Broadway spectacle such as this? You are looking at one of the RWA Tag Team Champions in Sean Leader. But tonight, instead of defending those titles, he has an even taller task to take on. For he has been locking horns with Frank Bones throughout different times of 2022. And these guys are tied 1-1. There is not so much a bad blood brewing between these two, but a quest, a desire, a need to know just which one is the alpha. And we're gonna find out here tonight.
This is why I'm here, and this is what I do. I fight the fight!
Introducing his opponent, from Lowell, Massachusetts, weighing at 135 pounds, he is the Vice Finisher, Frank Bones!
Frank Bones is come into his own like a fine wine, truly aging better with time, specifically here in this year 2022. Ever since winning the Jeremy Bell Invitational and holding the Jeremy Bell, he has been on more than just a hot streak. He has been a man fighting with purpose. He has been a man fighting with passion, and tonight all of that gets unleashed against Sean Leader.
Bobby Rossi, how are we doing tonight, my friend?
Bob, I'm fantastic. I am feeling those jitters that you feel when this stuff is brandy new to you. And sure, we've been around a little while, but this is a special one. This right here is not your average run-of-the-mill RWA show. We're going Broadway.
That's right. We got the best seat in the house, I think, right?
We certainly do. We lucked out tonight, my friend.
Absolutely.
Up close and personal to the ringside action. Whoa! Big pump kick thrown early on. And these two, they are no strangers to one another, Bob. They have been on one another's radar all year long. This is going to be intense.
Certainly some fast-paced action to kick it off here at RWA Goes Broadway. If I'm not mistaken here, Bobby, Bones has never beat Sean Leader one-on-one.
That is correct. His only victory over Sean Leader has been at the Fantasy Draft Tag Match that took place at this year's Devil's Night. Although he did get the pinfall victory over Sean Leader, it was not in a singles match, and that's what's burning at him. That's what's eating at his insides. That's why this means so much to him tonight.
There's been this professional rivalry between the two for so long, and I think tonight it's really gotten to the point where they're going to see once and for all who's the better man.
And as are everyone else in attendance, but look, you're looking at the technical prowess on display right now, Sean Leader, ever so unorthodox. Look at this! Creating a whole lot of velocity early on, but Bones stops him dead in his tracks. He saw it coming.
He knows Leader very well, and look at this. He's getting him in that crab position, trying to lock it in, cinch it in. All the weight being put onto the back of Leader right now.
Sean Leader is scrambling, and he makes reach, forcing the rope break to take place.
We know Tom Billington will be in action later on. Billington gave the blessing for Leader to compete here in singles competition tonight. We also know that Billington has a partner of his choosing. We'll find out who that's going to be later on tonight.
Oh! Big European uppercut thrown by Frank Bones. Hops over the top rope onto the apron of the ring. Hits the enziguri right to Leader's cerebellum. Look at this. He makes a look. Whoa! Big exploder suplex! Sean Leader stops Frank Bones dead in his tracks. He's got him set in his crosshairs. What's he got in mind here?
Ooh.
Oh, he hits him with the shining wizard. Cover
two,
him!
Two count only. The one thing looking over the entire card for tonight is you have to understand that Frank Bones and Sean Leader, when paired together, they're probably the two most evenly matched going at it here tonight.
I couldn't agree more. I mean, the thing of it is, though, there are fine nuances and difference between their styles, and that's why it's made such a spectacle for our fans to watch. We'll cover here. Look at this. Two.
Shoulders almost down for that three. Tyler Calloway right there, and Leader connects with that boot.
Frank Bones has been deadened, and this has been a back-and-forth matchup just under the three-minute mark, and these guys have been balls to the wall since the opening bell. John Leader appears to be more the aggressor in this matchup. Frank Bones, though, breaks the hold. Two big right hands.
I don't know if our audio's catching it, but a split crowd right now between Bones and Leader. Look at this combination and series of maneuvers as Bones drives the head of Leader into that middle turnbuckle.
Went fishing for it earlier, he hits it this time around. Frank Bones is now in the driver's seat. He's got Leader reeling at the moment.
Leader on the mat trying to compose himself, Bones up and over there. Look at that! Using the leverage, goes for the cover, hooks the leg, center of the ring, could be over now.
Frank Bones is well aware of the submission speciality that Sean Leader brings to the table. But I'll tell you, for someone as innovative as the sci-fi psychopath, it is very easy to get caught slipping as his opponent. Frank Bones is not allowing that to happen. He is firmly in control. Wait a minute, Sean Leader looks to reverse that backslide attempt. I might be sitting corrected there, pal.
Look at this, a little back and forth struggle here. Leader finally over, see if he can capitalize on it.
Oh! Calloway insists this match will continue. That was a very, very close call, my friend.
And the crowd into the action. Once again, we want to thank the historic Columbus Theater for going ahead. Wait a minute.
Oh, look. I think he's going for that Mars attacks. It was successful back in the fight for Fabre this year, March.
Kuzma.
Stick to the action.
All right. Oh, look at that.
Big old soccer kick to the lower lumbar. Sean Leader's got him by the neck. What's he got in mind here?
Quick follow-up, too, by Leader. That's the thing. Roll up, though. Two. That's it.
The winner of this contest, Frank Bones.
And Frank Bones victorious here in the opening contest. The fight finisher gaining a victory here over Sean Leader, Bobby.
What a way to start RWA Goes Broadway in a fantastic back and forth one-on-one matchup between these two. A true testament to professional wrestling.
See if there's going to be a hand extended here. These two hard-fought battle to open it up at RWA Goes Broadway. We want to thank everybody who is watching us on our social media. We also, once again, want to thank the Columbus Theater for hosting us here. And, of course, thank all our fans. Look at the show of sportsmanship right now between Leader and Bones. Let's take it to the ring right now. Paul, Mr. Paul Burrows, is here with us. He's going to conduct an interview in ring right now with Frank Bones.
Frank, first and foremost, congratulations. That was an amazing win. Let's give it up for Frank Bones once again, ladies and gentlemen. Now, Frank, a lot of people have been wondering what exactly is going on in that head. When are you going to cash in your opportunity with the Jeremy Bell? You've been on quite a roll ever since you won this, and everybody is wondering, when it comes time, what decision is Frank Bones going to make?
Well, thank you. Thank you, Paul. Thanks to each and every one of you that showed up here tonight to support the RWA. And first and foremost, I couldn't have gotten this far without my man Jeremy Bell behind me. Without Jeremy Bell guiding me on a path in the RWA to become the first person ever to hold this belt. So when you ask me what I'm going to do,
gone but not forgotten. We miss you, Jeremy. We love you dearly, brother.
So when you ask me what I plan on doing, And how do I plan on invoking this bell? Well, you see, I've had a long time to think about it. Ready? What up, brother? But yeah, listen. This guy right here, Hollywood, Paul Andrew, better known as Pollywood, right? He's been in my ear for about a week now. I think you should hear what he has to say. Just give him a listen. Do me that favor. Just give him, let him have a listen.
All right, Frank. I'm gonna tell you, Frank. I've been watching, and hey, it's clear to see. In the October show, and tonight, you had Shawn Leader's number, baby. Yes, sir.
Who are you?
And I'm gonna shoot straight at you, Frank.
Who are you?
I'm giving you a straight shot to the top. I got the angles ready. I see nothing but RWA Tag Team Championships for people like Frank Bones and Greedy. So how about we go backstage? I'll give you an idea. You listen to what I have. Think about it, you step backstage, alright?
A little off the beaten path, if you ask me. Frank Bones having the opportunity to cash in the Jeremy Bell for a championship of his choosing. He has been, he's been on the road towards a singles title, and I'm not so sure what this, what Pollywood's got in mind here, but folks, at RWA Goes Broadway, anything is possible. I'm not quite sure what's going to get in the mind of Frank Bones, but you're going to have to stay tuned to find out. Let's take it to the ring with Bob Whitney.